Your eye has cataract. You need a cataract. Do you have diabetes? Your power is too high. Can't be fixed with glasses. Medicines, tablets, they won't help. You need surgery. There's no pain, there's no anything like you can't eat anything after a certain time. You can shower as much as you want. There's no restrictions after surgery. We'll take you to the UMA clinic. We'll get your IOL measurements. We'll get you the right lens. Once we have that set, you can come back to the Hyundai hospital. We'll do the operation. We'll put the correct lens. It'll fix the refractive error that you have, and it'll also replace the lens. He's asking if he wants to come right now. He can go to lunch and then come back at 1 so that we can take him to the UMA clinic. Once he gets checked, we'll bring him back. We'll bring him back here. The operation will be in 1 week. Do you want to come? He's saying that he'll be here at 1.
Can you see the red ring?
Yes.
The red ring should be coincident with the cornea. Now can you find out the flickering position?
Yes.
That just you have to hide open.
Okay, so
just you stay at the flickering position, automatically you can get the reading. This is a horizontal value of the 43.2 diopter. This is a millimeter. 7.8 is horizontal value of the millimeter. This is a 7.71 is the vertical value.
Okay. So this is a horizontal.
See that now I'm going vertically down. Can you see my probe? It's going like this.
Shouldn't be afraid to do that. This is enough.
Right. Now I'm adjusting my focus down.
So this particular patient has been a driver by profession, and because of the cataract and both eyes, he couldn't continue his driving job. So after the surgery, he has been operated yesterday. So after the surgery, he can see well, and he says that he wants to go and continue back his driving job and make at least 5-6,000 rupees a month. So cataract surgery through these programs actually improve the economic productivity of many families. So this man is quite young, so he can actually go back and do his driver's job. Some of the volunteers, we also encourage them to take up projects, study projects. So we found out that some of the volunteers are staying here for 1 month or 2 months. So in addition to going to camps, mastering of the skill, they are also encouraged to do study projects. To give you an example, we had a lot of interesting study projects. Some of the volunteers did a study on diabetic retinopathy. Some of them did studies on speculum microscopies. Pre and post cataract surgery. So, some volunteers did, they combined their special skills. Some of the volunteers are skillful in photography. So, we had a volunteer who did a project on photography. So, he was taking pictures of patients whom he saw in camps and whom before cataract surgery and after cataract surgery. So, there were a lot of interesting projects being done by volunteers through this program. So we always encourage volunteers to take up studies, and which was also interesting, and we also gained a lot of information from these studies.
நான் அவர்கிட்ட கொஞ்சம் தண்ணி பேசிட்டு வந்தேன். இது
வந்து முக்கியமான வேலை இருந்தது, அதனாலதான் நான்
I got the far distance, I don't know.
Okay.
To see far distance.
Yes. Is it?
And always I get a headache.
A headache.
And vomiting.
Okay, yeah. Does it affect your life?
Huh?
Does it affect your job, life?
Yes, yes.
Okay,
yes.
Yeah. How long have you had the problem?
I got from 5 years.
5 years ago. Okay.
I got hurt in backside.
Oh, okay.
Very long time ago.
Was it an accident?
Accident, no. Yeah. But from top, wooden fell down in my.
Okay, okay.
I got painted.
Oh, okay, okay. Yeah.
So I got 8 stitches in my back.
Oh. Okay.
So from that time, I get a headache. Right. And vomiting.
Have you had your eyes checked before?
No.
No, first time?
Yeah.
First time, okay, that's good. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
What is your job? She just stays at home. Do you have any children? She has 4 children. Her husband just stays at home.
She's
the only one that stays at home.
Her
husband stays with his brother.
There's
2 houses and she takes care of both of them. When did she have this problem?
Mm-hmm.
One eye, she has paint has fallen on her eye. It's been almost 10 years ago. She was painting. She was painting one of the houses. And she thought that she could do the painting. It was just sitting there, you know, it needed to be done. So she decided to do it. She painted this. It took her almost 1 week to 1 month to actually go to a hospital to check it out. She went later. They told her that she needed an operation for that eye, but she just left. And didn't do anything about it. So how are you living with one eye? So the eye that the pin has fallen is blind and she didn't get an operation. How is she working with one eye? She's just getting by. How long has that eye with the cataract, how long has that been there? Almost four months she's noticed that it's a significant problem. But beforehand, she was just getting by. But before that, she's been doing everything on her own, has been taking care of herself. How do you know about this services? I know this because there was a van and I just came to it. But how do you know that? How do you know that it's free? Other people have told her that this is a free service. That's why she decided to come. It's very nice that this is free. That would be good. Once you have complete vision after the surgery, what would you say? I'd say
Bergamathan, and I just graduated from college with a biomedical engineering degree, and I'll be starting medical school within a month. I actually found out about Unite for Sight online as I was looking for clinical opportunities to do in Chennai, India, which is my native homeland. So I feel that volunteering with Unite for Sight really has helped me accomplish my primary goal of gaining clinical experience in an international setting. It's amazing how living conditions are for people here. It's sometimes very much below the standard of Americans, and it's very interesting to see how people can survive in conditions like these. And then we bring eye cams to these places, and we can do a full, complete eye scan and for these patients, and then give them eyeglasses if necessary. And then sometimes that's all they need to just go about the house, do their day-to-day things, and everything to them is so much clearer. But then for a lot of patients, especially the older ones, they have cataracts, and sometimes they're just really surprised that they came here thinking that they could just get glasses and all their, and then their vision will be completely clear, but then we're telling them that they need surgery. So sometimes they're very hesitant at first, and they're very confused as to why they need surgery, but then it's very interesting to see how doctors and the counselors interact with patients and try to convince them and sort of console them on how the surgery is. It's not painful. They will be able to see very clearly after the surgery, and transportation cost is nothing that they have to worry about. And it was very interesting to see this interaction, because the cultural norm and the beliefs are very different, and the way that one approaches these issues is also very different. So it was very interesting to see these interactions. Also, as a volunteer, we were able to take the patients from the camps to the eye clinics. And in the eye clinic, at the MRI clinic, we were able to observe the doctors interacting with the patient, as well as actually learn how to use the instrument, various instruments that are there, and even perform basic measurements using these instruments. And then at the Hyundai Hospital, which is where the operation takes place, we were not only allowed to observe the operation within the operation theater, we were also allowed to do the pre-op, prep the patient before the operation, which was to dilate the patient as well as cut their eyelashes and just, you know, make sure that they're ready for operation. The post-op was really my favorite part of the entire program, because it was just really amazing to see after the bandage was taken off of their eye how sometimes they may say that the world around them is a lot brighter, and they're worried that we may have done something wrong. It's amazing to see that they may have lived in such darkness and such a dim light that all of a sudden they're seeing so much light and they think that something is wrong. But it's amazing to see that they're happy, they can see clearer, especially the grandparents or the older people are able to see their grandchildren for the first time after a few years. And it's always just really nice to know that you were part of that in some way. So that was one of my best experiences with Unite for Sight, was in the post-op. All the doctors and all the staff are very approachable. They are great teachers. They want to help, and they want to make sure that you learn how to use the instruments, that you learn about the culture and how to approach it, that you are also able to experience the city that you're living in for the period of time. And so they're willing to help. So definitely take advantage of them. Make sure that you ask the questions that you have. They're very willing to help. My advice for this program is to not be discouraged, or to remain flexible about the new culture that you're going to immerse yourself in. It may seem very too much to handle, that everything is so different. But after some time, usually for me it took about a week, it was so much better. Nothing changed, but I feel like I've changed, and I was able to understand the culture a lot better. I was more open to it, and I feel that in the beginning I may have not liked it as much just because it was so different, but then once I came and lived here and everything, I feel like I've learned a lot from it, and it's definitely, learning a new culture is a great experience. I hope your experience with Unite for Sight is as life-changing as it was for me.
So through Unite for Sight and combined effort of Vision Foundation, a lot of achievements have been done in the Chennai program. With more than 100 volunteers coming every year, we were doing, if you take statistics of 2008, we have done 1,300, this is just a conservative estimate, we have done around 1,300 surgeries, free of cost. All these surgeries are high quality phacoemulsification surgeries done by very good surgeons with top of the line equipment. So most 99.5% of the patients had 100% near normal visual recovery. In terms of camps, we conduct around 20 outreach programs every month. So there have been around 240 outreach programs which has been conducted in the full year of 2009. Each of these programs, outreach camps, we screen a minimum of 100 patients. So around 25,000 patients have been screened during the past 1 year. And more than 10,000 people have got glasses. So this has been an enormous achievement, which has been a combined effort of Unite for Sight, the clinic, the doctors, and most importantly, the volunteers. So this kind of a large-scale program would never happen without a joint effort. So we would like to congratulate Jennifer Staples and Unite for Sight for envisioning a program of such a large scale and implementing it to such a great extent. And we in future hope to expand this program to a lot more hospitals and more number of volunteers can come. Scale up the program, that is what is the basic aim of the group. So maybe we can do 600 outreach programs every year, do 3,000 cataract surgeries every year. So we are trying to gradually scale up the program, and it's been scaling up for the past 5 years. So that should